In the previous video, we left Aaron's bus being delivered to the shop. And although this video is not a how-to on how to rebuild an 8V92, we just really wanted to show some of the work that went into getting Aaron's bus back on the road. This is the old head that came off the bus. It's all rusted because once we pulled it off, we set them outside and they've been rained on and everything. So none of these parts are going back into the new bus and to the new heads. We will be taking these pieces off and a couple of ports and stuff like that. But the head itself actually has a crack between the injector and the valves, and so this is all just waste, so it wasn't all that important to protect it from getting rusty. This has been sitting outside for about 2 weeks, and that just goes to show what can happen when parts are sitting out in the weather.
Now they've actually stopped with the motor over there, you can kind of see what I'm doing. So basically what I'm doing is I'm cleaning out all these, basically this is where the O-rings are going to go, and these are the actual main components here that are going to actually seal the head against the top of the engine block here. So those need to get all cleaned out. The other thing is I've been having some struggle with is there's a ring that goes all the way around these liners here. That ring also needs to get replaced, so I've got to get these rings out, and there's like no clearance in there at all to get any kind of tool in there to grab them. So that's actually what I'm currently working on. I think most of these are kind of cleaned out. I'll go over them once more, but pop these out, and this side should be ready for a good cleaning.
These are the inspection ports. Yeah, if I can get some light up under there, you can see where the slots are in the sleeves. It's where air comes in. And we're in the process of putting the inspection plates back in. This is Aaron's lot in life.
Cleaning.
Leaning over a bucket of diesel cleaning parts. Is this the order?
It doesn't really matter. They're marked on the bottom.
Oh.
But yeah. We'll leave that last one up there. Or ready.
Yeah. Ah. No. interesting about these bearings. That one looks like it's worn, but it, you don't feel anything.
Yeah.
We are getting ready to put the first of two heads on this engine. Got everything cleaned up, got all of the cylinders cleaned up, still got washers to put in and all of that, and then we'll put a cover over this hole here so we don't fall off into the pit. So the plan is we use this cherry picker, pick up this head, and we'll precariously dangle it over the pit of death and slide it into there. So what we have is a guide stud. It's a bolt with a head cut off of it, and we'll bring the head in over on top of that, and we'll line it up with one of the holes, and then we'll slide the whole head down on that, and it'll bring the head down nice and straight so that we don't knock any of the washers out.
Thank you. down now.
Down just a little bit.
Yep. One more.
Raise up on your way.
They look good?
Well, we're going to start putting compound on now. Fun, ain't it?
Pretty amazing. Something you don't see every day.
Are you starting the threads?
If he tells you from the time, I think Larry's 67 right now, from the time he was a teenager, he started running the business. He started doing the stuff that, from the way they made an engine then,
yep,
and the way they are now, whole engine was mechanical. The way they are made and how they just change in a 5 year period, 10 year period, everything is just unbelievable.
You got some on your fingers, didn't you?
You got your fingers dirty.
Yeah. You're like me, it's like, ah! Fingers dirty.
I got one more head stud.
You don't want to leave that chain in there for next time? You might have a little router.
Injectors in place. What's next?
Getting ready to torque down the head.
Torque down the head.
That's pretty long bolts.
Don't matter. Because you got to go through the plate.
Yep, less than that.
And it just sit there in the corner. Yep. Like that.
Yep.
So the shoulder, see how long the shoulder is right there?
Mm-hmm.
Talk on the head.
Get up in here. We got the injectors are in place. Put some. Got to torque these down right here. These holders, injector holders. All of the head bolts have been torqued down, and we got a bracket in the back put on. We got a fuel line here. Fuel line in the back put on. Got a drain tube back there. And so now we're ready to torque down the keepers that hold these injectors in place. That small nut in between the two, what does that do?
Well, it gets a little pressure from one to the other to activate it.
Okay.
When I was pulling this down, I was damaging the rock washer, the washer. That's why I loosened it all up. Then I can tighten it up after. Get it back down.
So is there a gasket between the two?
Yeah, let me show you.
Yes, sir. Please.
don't sound right. Is the bolt creaking?
Larry here.
I'm seeing it come down quite a bit.
Yeah. But I'm right in between, but yeah. Okay, I think we should be.
Come down support. As long as you hold it like that.
Sitting on his butt.
Yeah, I know. I'm trying to get past it. It's
so I'm feeling that good, huh? I need to pick up.
Well, the sitting unit's got it. I'm in about 4 inches. Almost there.
That's me now.
Right there.
Right there?
Right there.
Damn shit, ain't
it? Yeah.
Great, you're gonna drop it down just a tad easy. Score! Easy now. I hear you.
Look up and see what's hanging it. Pull it back to you.
Yeah.
Tighten on the center. Tighten up on the jack first a little bit.
Go up a little.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then pull backwards. Oh, that's not
right.
Now pull backwards on the jack. There you go. Now inch it down.
Now go down?
Yeah.
Going down?
Yeah.
Still okay? My gas was still good?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh!
Good job.
You're doing good.
Wait a minute. You have nothing about this
year. Oh, alright. Then come up then.
Go up a little?
Yeah. You don't have to go up about 4 inches.
You want me to go up?
Yeah. All right, that's enough.
That's good?
Yeah.
All
we have got everything put back on this engine. Gotta light up here, get back out of the way. We're getting just about ready for first start. Aaron is over filling up his fuel filter. We'll put a fuel filter right there and we'll be ready to go. Well, we got a little bit of a setback. This thermostat housing right here, we got a replacement for, and turns out it has a crack in it right down here at the bottom. So we're gonna find another one and replace that. But it's not gonna stop us from a first start.
different when we took the damn air filters out.
Sprayed ether up there, yeah.
Yeah, I just wondered if that damn air filter clogged up.
Oh.
Put it back in there and see if it stopped.
Yeah. Well, it sounds good.
Sounds real good.
Yeah. Sort of stumbled a little bit there when he hit the treadle valve.
Very first acceleration?
Yeah.
My foot slipped off.
Oh. Yeah, but there was something, it was like it was missing back here.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
But it cleared out right away, so it may have been an air bubble or something going through.
There though, I turned on the fast idle,
Start it back here?
Yeah, I figured that way we can
close your in.
Okay.
Make sure the whole pool ring works.
Good thing about being a little taller.
That's why he had you do it.